Hello everybody. Now we will discuss this triangle. Part 1 we are taking. So first of all we will try to understand the figures, means by the observation. Simply by observation we will discuss which figures will be the similar and which will be the congruent. Keval observation se, by observation. So koi bhi do figures similar kab hote hain? Any two figures will be the similar if they are same and size. Both are same. If the shape as well as the size, shape or size both are same, then these figures are known as similar. For instance, you are taking the two line segment like AB. Its length is 2 cm. This we are not worried about the sizes here only. Only the shape. Shape must be the same. We are not worried about the size. Shape must be the same to become a similar. AB and another line segment you are taking, suppose PQ, that is the 4 cm. They are the similar. Shape must be the same. Any two circles you are taking, that this is your radius R1, another circle you are taking, radius is R2, even R1 is not equal to R2, they are the similar. Two triangles you are taking, shape must be the same. We are not worried about the size. Shape same hona chahiye. Shape must be the same. We are not worried about the other things. Shape, agar same hai, they are the similar. For instance, you are taking, let's suppose the two squares, they are also the similar. And the sign of similarity is, sign of similarity, this is the sign which we use for the similarity. So this is by observation. Kisi ko dekh karke comment karna, they are the similar. So to become a similar, shape must be the same. If the shape is same, they are the similar. But to become a congruent, shape and size, both must be same. Means both the condition must be fulfilled at the same time. Dono condition ek saath fulfill karni chahiye. Shape as well as size is same hai, they are the congruent. But this is we are doing by observation. Keval observation se we are going to give the comment. By observation, remember. By observation, this one. Later on we will discuss how can you make the congruents, the triangles. So to become a congruent, shape and size both must be the same. For instance, you are taking, suppose A line, AB is a line segment, you are taking 2 cm. This is PQ. The length must also be the 2 cm. Two circles you are taking, radius is suppose 2 cm. Another circle, radius must be the same, 2 cm. Two triangles, shape and size, both should be the same at the same time. They are the congruent, you can say. Two squares you are taking. Shape and size should be the same. And sign of congruency is, sign of congruency, this is the sign of the congruency. You must draw the two line parallel and this like S is there. So this is the sign of the congruency is there only. So important point is here, if we compare these two, see now, to become a similar, shape must be the same. We are not worried about the size. But to become a congruent, shape and size both must be the same. It means you can say every congruent figures are similar. Every congruent figures are always similar. Always. Always similar. But converse is not always true. Converse is not always true. This one. Means those who are the congruent, you can say they are the similar also. But they are the similar, it doesn't mean they will be the congruent. To become a congruent, same. But this is simply by the observation. Just simply by observation. Keval samajhne ke liye hum, we are discussing this one only. Because by the observation, exact answer we cannot give. For instance, suppose AB's, the length is given 2 cm. PQ, another line segment is there, whose length is suppose 1.9 cm. Suppose, for instance, you are taking, suppose, or you can see the RQ is there. But this AB, the length is not equal. Length is not equal. Lekin agar hum dekhenge, toh it look like the same. This is also 2 cm. AB as a 2 cm lagega. So you cannot say. But this is simply by the observation. Have a look. Yes. Now, we will discuss the criteria for congruence of triangles. When the two triangles will be the congruent is there. So first is case is there. Any two triangles, koi bhi do triangle congruent honge, if the side angle side means two sides and included angle. This angle is in metal means this is included angle. If the two side and included angle is equal, you can declare they are the congruent. For instance, maan lijiye, suppose AB is equal to PQ, AB is equal to PQ, and BC is equal to QR. Then the included angle between these two sides, the sides which are given equal, unke beech ka angle, angle B is equal to C, angle Q, then you can declare the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Here is the important point is here only, the two sides and this is your included angle, remember. Ye kya hai? Unke beech ka included angle must be equal. If the included angle is not equal, then you cannot say the congruent. For instance, maan lijiye, agar main ye kahun, for instance, suppose AB is equal to is PQ, this is given, BC is equal to QR is also given, and but angle B is equal to angle A. So with this property, you cannot say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. These are not the congruent. To become a congruent, two sides and included angle must be equal. Agar ye side iske equal hai and this side is equal to this one, then angle between these two sides must be equal, then you can say they are the congruent. See now, one more point is there. Once you are, just see, look at here now, one more point we will discuss here now. After the congruency that I am going to discuss, see now, suppose, for instance, we are taking the triangle ABC and triangle PQR. We are taking suppose. And if I am saying AB is equal to PQ, AB is equal to PQ, and this AC is equal to PR, AC is equal to PR, and angle A is equal to angle P, angle A is equal to angle P, it means then you can say the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. The important point is there, once you said the triangles are congruent, agar aapne bola ki ye triangle congruent hai, after that you can say one, two points is keep in mind, ki do point aapko dhyan rakhna hai. One is, if the triangles are the congruent, then equal sides opposite angles are equal. Means once you proved then both the triangles are the congruent. It means ye jo side AB hai, iske opposite angle this one will be equal to this angle, opposite side angle R. And similarly, equal angles opposite sides are equal. This is the very very important point you must keep in mind only. Agar if this angle A is equal to angle P hai, then this side BC will be equal to this QR. BC side will be equal to the QR. So this is the two points you must keep in mind. Once the triangle are congruent. Agar toh triangle congruent aapne declare kar diye, after that you want to talk about the other angles or other side. Toh triangle congruent karne ke baad, aap other angles or side ke baare mein baat karna chahte hain, toh important point ye hai, equal sides, opposite angles. This side is equal to this one, then this angle, will be equal to this one is there. Similarly, if suppose this angle is equal to this one, then this BC will be equal to QR, or angle C is equal to angle R hai, then this AB will be equal to PQ. Once after that, the triangles are the congruent. One more point. If you proved that triangles are the congruent, it means angle A will be equal to angle P, angle B will be equal to angle Q, angle C will be equal to angle R, and similarly the sides. First AB will be equal to PQ, BC will be equal to QR, and this AC will be equal to this PR. This is the very very important point. So once you are going to write here only, jab aap yahan do triangle ko congruent likh rahe hain, to ye bhi aapko dhyan rakhna hai kaun sa angle kiske barabar hai, and which side is equal to this one. Here only have a look. Okay, one more point we will discuss here. Let's suppose these two triangles are given, और हमने बोला कि ये ट्रायंगल एबीसी से कॉन्वर्ट टू ट्रायंगल पीक्यूआर है. इट मींस अगर आपने लिखा ट्रायंगल एबीसी कॉर्नर टू एंगल पी क्यू आर, इट मीन्स यू शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल कि देन एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी, वी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू आर क्यू एंड सी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू आर, वन थिंग. एंड सिमिलरली ए बी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू पी क्यू, बी सी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू क्यू क्यू आर एंड ए सी लेंथ मस्ट बी इक्वल टू दिस पी आर. Suppose you are going to write triangle ABC is congruent to QPR, QRP, it means angle A is equal to angle Q, angle B is equal to angle R, and angle C is equal to angle P. Similarly, AB will be equal to QR, BC will be equal to this RP, and AC length will be equal to this QP is there only. So you should be very, very careful what you are exactly you are going to write. See, and one more point is here only. Suppose by taking this property I am taking, suppose if we prove this triangle, these two triangles are the congruent, I said then AB is equal to PQ and BC is equal to QR and angle B is equal to angle Q. This is by using this SAS, by using the SAS congruence rule, we proved them both the triangles are the congruent. Aapne ye prove kiya ki by SAS both the triangles are the congruent. Now you want to talk about the other angles. Aap other angles ya other side ke baare mein baat karna chahte hain. To once you proved the triangles are the congruent, उसके बाद डायरेक्ट यू कैन राइट डाउन. सपोज बाय टेकिंग दिस प्रॉपर्टी हम देखें कि हमने ये इसको किया AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR and angle B is equal to Q. Then we want to say AC is equal to PR. You want to say AC is equal to PR. So that you can say this is by CPCT. CPCT means that is the corresponding part. Part of congruent triangles. So direct by using this one, you can say corresponding part means C we are taking here. Corresponding part ka P le rahe, congruent ka C and triangle ka T. So by the CPCT direct you can say after prove the triangles are the congruent. जब दो triangle congruent हो जाते हैं उसके बाद बिंदास कुछ भी बोलिए. लेकिन one thing is keep in mind, equal side opposite angles, equal angle opposite sides are equal. Here is the angle B is equal to Q है, that's why we are saying that AC is equal to PR. First of all, तो आपको यही ध्यान रखना है कि how you are going to write this here on. You should be very very careful in case you are going to write the triangles are the congruent. And then by CPCT. Similarly, you can say suppose you want to say this angle C is equal to angle R, you can say this is also by the CPCT. Angle A is equal to angle P, this is also by the CPCT. Simple, directly you can say this one is there. So sometime we will use this CPCT is there. That is the corresponding part of congruent triangles. Have a look. Now, the second property is there. You can make the two triangles are the congruent by angle, side angle. Side means here is the included side. The two angles we are taking, then side should be included. Then you can declare both the triangles are the congruent. Just see for example, ABC and PQ are the two triangles. I am saying angle B is equal to angle Q and angle C is equal to angle R, then BC must be equal to QR. Or you can say, jo side equal hai, usi par angle agar equal hai, you can declare both the triangles are the congruent. It means two angles and included side. Jis side par, jo side equal hai, usi par angle equal honi chahiye, you can declare. Suppose yahan par agar aisa hota, for instance, ye hota ki angle B is equal to angle Q hai, angle A is equal to angle P hai and BC side is equal to angle R hai. You cannot say that the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. This is the. So means included side. Jis jo angle de rakhe hai, wahi side equal. Here we are saying A is equal to P and B is equal to Q. Then AB must be equal to PQ. Then only you can say the other congruent. Just for instance, sometime children may be confused in this case only. Suppose for example these two figures are given. This is given 60 degree, this is given 40, and this is 40 and 60. But this side is equal to this one. Then you cannot say the triangle ABC is congruent to this one. This is not congruent. Triangle ABC cannot be congruent to triangle this one here. Means no doubt by the sum of the property of the angles, sum is of the angle is 180, so this will be the 80 and this one also is the 80. So here you are seeing that this is 40 and 60 degree just angle hai, wo side yaha 60, 80 and 40 angle hai, that side is equal. It doesn't mean they will be the congruent, they will not be the congruent. So you should be very careful, that is the included side is there. Sometime we are saying, kai baar isko aise bolte hain, in place of A, S, A, people are saying A, A, S. If you are saying AAS means if two angles are equal, then no doubt at all. For instance, मान लीजिए मैंने एक ABC triangle लिया, another triangle I am taking, suppose PQR. This is. Then I said this is your angle the 40, and this is your 80, and this is 40, and this is your 80. 80 is here only. Suppose I am taking this is your 60. Suppose for example. So and then I am saying this side is equal to this one, and I am saying this angle 60, and here is also I am taking. See, the important point is here. The 60, 40, 60 I am taking, and this is also the 60 is there only. Then these two angles are equal, and one of the side we are saying. So, jo bhi side hoga, if I am saying this BC is equal to QR, no, it should be equal to this one. You have to calculate this one. Either it may be, sometime it may be like this side is equal to this one. This angle, third angle, you have to calculate it. These two angles are given, these two are given, and this side is given is AB, is which is equal to this one. So, by the sum of the property, you can find out this one. So, ultimately, what you are getting, ki jo side QR hai and AB hai, un par the angles equal hai. So, ultimately, it will come the included is there. Included side will there only. Third angle nikalne ke baad included side hoga. So, this is your seven properties there. By using this one only, you can make that angles are the congruent. Have a look. Yes, now this is the question from your exercise 7.1. Question number 1 is here. What is the question is there? Question is keh raha hai, there is a quadrilateral ACBD. ACBD is a quadrilateral, and it is given AC is equal to AD. This side AC is equal to AD is already given, and AB. AB is bisect this angle A. Bisect means it is divided into two equal parts. We are supposed to show that then that these two triangles are the congruent, and then we want to give the comment about BC and BD. What will be about the BC and BD that we want to. So, whatever the information is given, usse pehle aap likhiye yahan par. So, this is given quadrilateral ACBD, and AC is equal to AD is also given, and AB is going to bisect this angle A. So, for the own convenience, you can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. And we want to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD. What we want to prove? We want to prove the triangle ABC and this triangle ABC and triangle ABD. These two triangles we want to make a congruent is here only. Important point ye hai ki the triangles which you want to make the congruent, unko pehle yahan likhiye. Just you must write down in triangle ABC and triangle ABD. Just this is there only. अब नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द एग्जैक्ट पोजिशन. हमेशा ध्यान रखिए ज्योमेट्री इज द इजीएस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द मैथमेटिक्स यू कैन से. सबसे ज्यादा इजी है ज्योमेट्री, लेकिन बच्चे बहुत भयभीत रहते हैं अफेयर्ड विद दिस ज्योमेट्री. ज्योमेट्री टफ है. नो, ज्योमेट्री इज द वेरी इजी पार्ट ऑफ द मैथमेटिक्स यू कैन से. देखिए इन दिस एक्सरसाइज आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली दिस एक्सरसाइज, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द होल ज्योमेट्री इज देयर ओनली नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड का. देखिए हमने डिस्कस किया क्या था कि वी कैन मेक द टू ट्रायंगल्स बाय द साइड एंगल साइड और बाई एंगल साइड एंगल. सो दीज टू कंडीशन क्राइटेरिया वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस बाई विच वी कैन मेक द ट्रायंगल्स आर द कॉन्वेंट. सी किसी भी क्वेश्चन को देख लो, किसी भी क्वेश्चन को हमको केवल केवल एक चीज सर्च करना है. टू थिंग्स विल बी गिवन, दो चीज ऑलरेडी गिवन होंगी इन दिस वन. टू विल बी गिवन आइदर द वन साइड वन एंगल, यू हैव टू सर्च वन साइड, और द वन एंगल वन साइड में भी गिवन, यू हैव टू सर्च द एंगल. Sometimes the two side is there given, you have to search one angle. Only one. केवल एक चीज को हमें ढूंढना पड़ता है, और वही एक चीज बच्चों को लगता है पता नहीं क्या ढूंढ रहा है. यू शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल इन ऑल द क्वेश्चंस. ओनली वन थिंग यू आर सपोज टू सर्च, रेस्ट ऑफ द इन्फॉर्मेशन विल बी गिवन इन ए क्वेश्चन. पूरी इन्फॉर्मेशन क्वेश्चन के अंदर होती है. बार बार उसे पढ़ो, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिया क्या. अब देखिए इसने बोला क्वाड्रिलेटरल ACBD. पहले तो देखिए बाय द वे हियर इज अ फिगर इज गिवन. बाय द वे फिगर इज गिवन, सो देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम. इफ इट इज अ फिगर इज नॉट गिवन, सपोज हियर इज गिवन ए क्वाड्रिलेटरल इन क्वाड्रिलेटरल ACBD. फिगर इज नॉट गिवन, क्वाड्रिलेटरल ACBD. बच्चे क्या करते हैं जल्दी में ABCD लिखेंगे, ABCD, बट इट इज गिवन ACBD. तो यू शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल इफ यू आर गोइंग टू रीड द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन को पढ़ रहे हैं तो ध्यान से पढ़िए क्या गिवन है क्या नहीं. Here is the information is given here. AC is equal to AD. This is already given. And AB is going to bisect angle this one. Angle 1 is equal to 2 is also given. अब लुक एट हियर नाउ, मैंने क्या बोला, केवल एक चीज सर्च करना है इन दोनों में. देखो इंटरेस्ट ट्रायंगल एबीसी, एबीसी एंड ट्रायंगल एबीडी. सी नाउ एडी इज इक्वल टू एसी ऑलरेडी गिवन है, एडी इज इक्वल टू एसी, दिस इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, हमको ऑलरेडी गिवन है ना. एंगल 1 इज इक्वल टू एंगल 2 इज आल्सो गिवन. तो देखिए दो इंफॉर्मेशन तो ऑलरेडी गिवन है. इस मीन से हुआ कि अगर मैं दिस क्राइटेरिया को देखूं तो वन साइड वन एंगल, तो देखिए वन साइड वन एंगल इज हियर एंड वन साइड वन एंगल इज आल्सो हियर. तो वी हैव ओनली वन ऑप्शन, या तो मेरे को एक साइड सर्च करना है या एक एंगल. अब तो एंगल तो इसमें दिया ही नहीं है, ओनली दिस इज गिवन, द इंफॉर्मेशन इज गिवन अबाउट दिस वन. और जो गिवन होता है ना उसी से हमें पता चलता है हमें करना क्या है. तो दिस एंगल इज नॉट गिवन, इसका मतलब ये क्राइटेरिया तो हमारा आउट हो गया, पर्टिकुलर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. इट मीन्स यू आर सपोज टू सर्च वन ऑफ द साइड. अब साइड क्या सी होनी चाहिए, जो साइड विच मेक्स द एंगल इंक्लूडेड, विच मेक्स द एंगल इंक्लूडेड, इंक्लूडेड वो साइड. अब देखो ये साइड इसके बराबर, ये एंगल इसके बराबर, तो ये साइड में दोनों इंक्लूड कर रहे हैं कि नहीं. ये साइड इज कॉमन इन बोथ द ट्रायंगल्स. तो करना क्या है भाई, केवल एक बार देखो, एबी इज इक्वल टू बी ए, दैट इज कॉमन. So you can say the triangle ABC is common to triangle ABD by SAS rule. And once the triangles are the congruent, अगर दोनों ट्रेंगल कॉन्वेंट हो गए उसके बाद बिंदास लिख दीजिए. वो क्या पूछ रहा है, BC इक्वल BD क्या होगा, दोनों कॉन्वेंट है तो डेफिनेटली दे विल बी इक्वल. बट दिस इज ऑल्सो वी डिस्कस कि इक्वल एंगल अपोजिट साइड इक्वल होती है, तो वो सब समझने की जरूरत नहीं. सीधा once the triangles are the congruent, जो रेस्ट ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन बाई सीबीसीडी, हेंस यू कैन से बीसी इक्वल टू बीडी, सिंपल लिखो बिंदास बाई सीबीसीडी, बस ओवर. दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन इज देयर ओनली. तो केवल केवल एक चीज, ओनली वन केवल एक चीज सर्च करना पड़ता है, रेस्ट ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी गिवन इन ए क्वेश्चन. चलो okay, one more question is there from your exercise. Question number 2 is there. ABCD is a quadrilateral is given. AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to BC is already given. And the angle DAB, this angle, look at here, this angle is equal to this one is given. And we are supposed to prove that this one, triangle, first of all, ABD congruent to triangle this BAC. And BD is equal to AC and this one is there only. So, direct I am going to do. This is already written. So, I have to write. Written the given is here, then direct proof is there. आपको एग्जाम में अगर क्वेश्चन आता है तो यू मस्ट राइट ऑन द टू प्रूफ इज हियर ऑनली. यू मस्ट नोट डाउन दीज थ्री स्टेप्स. सो डायरेक्ट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक दिस वन नाउ. लुक एट हियर, इन दोनों में अगेन सेम थिंग, दो इन्फॉर्मेशन गिवन होंगी, हमें केवल एक सर्च करना, ओनली वन. अब देखो बिंदास, इन ट्रायंगल ए बी डी, ए डी इज इक्वल टू ए डी, इन ट्रायंगल बी ए सी, बी सी इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, दिस इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, दिस इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, एक इंफॉर्मेशन. सेकेंड ये एंगल देखो बिंदास, इन ट्रायंगल दिस एबीडी, दिस एंगल ए, एंगल डीएबी, एंड इन दिस एंगल एबीसी, दिस एंगल बी, दैट इज एंगल सीबीए, दिस इज आल्सो गिवन. सो अगेन एसएएस आइदर एएसए, तो वन साइड वन एंगल, वन साइड वन एंगल, आइदर यू आर सपोज टू सर्च वन साइड और वन एंगल इज हियर. तो दूसरा एंगल तो यहां दिया ही नहीं है ना, अदर अनदर एंगल इज नॉट गिवन, इट मीन्स यू हैव टू सर्च द वन साइड. अब ध्यान से देखो, इन ट्रायंगल दिस एबीडी, इन दिस ट्रायंगल एबीडी, इन ट्रायंगल एबीसी, व्हिच साइड इज कॉमन, दिस इज द साइड व्हिच इज कॉमन, दिस इज कॉमन. सो यू कैन राइट डाउन एबी इज इक्वल टू बीए एंड दैट इज कॉमन. सो यू कैन से द ट्रायंगल एबीडी इज कॉमन टू ट्रायंगल बीएसी बाय SAS rule, that you can say. And once the triangle are congruent, अब ये जो तो part दिए ना, ये उसी में देखो ध्यान से. In BD is equal to AC, तो BD is what? This one is BD. In triangle this one and AC is this one. And if we talk about the angle ABD, ABD, this is your angle, this angle, and BAC, this angle, this one. Same triangles में, तो इसको बिंदास लिखो सीधा. Hence, सीधा लिख दीजिए. BD is equal to AC. And this is angle ABD is equal to angle BAC by CPCT. खत्म, over. तो केबल और केबल, ध्यान से देखो, केवल एक चीज, only one, केवल एक चीज ढूंढनी पड़ती है. और भाई जब एक चीज, only one thing we are going to search, after that you are saying the geometry is very tough. Geometry is very easy. Only one thing, only one, केवल एक. Now have a look.